welcome the dignitaries with a thundering round of applause. Please join me in welcoming on dais Honorable Dilip Vengsarkar, international cricketer, and the chief guest of the function, Dr. Shivendra Gupta, Honorable Vice Chancellor, V. Dharmad South Gujarat University, Dr. Rajendra Patel, in charge Registrar, V. Narmad South Gujarat University, Sri David Paul, Director of Physical Education and Youth Welfare. I also take this opportunity to welcome all the dignitaries, members of Senate and Syndicate, deans of various faculties, professors, university officials, administrative staff, teaching and non-teaching staff of the university, representatives of the various media houses, parents, students, teachers, and ladies and gentlemen. I once again take this opportunity to welcome all of you to this closing ceremony and prize distribution ceremony of 47th Youth Festival, V. Narmad South Gujarat University. Asambhav ki seema janne ka ek tarika hai. Asambhav ki seema janne ka ek tarika hai. Asambhav se bhi aage chale jana. और जो असंभव से आगे चले जाते हैं उसे हम युवान कहते हैं. टुडे इंसिडेंटली दिस इज द बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ आवर यूथ आइकॉन एंड द ग्रेटेस्ट इंडियन सोल स्वामी विवेकानंद. इट इज अ बिग कोइंसिडेंस दैट वी आर क्लोजिंग दिस यूथ फेस्टिवल ऑन दिस इंडियन यूथ डे. आई वुड रीड सम ऑफ द इंस्पायरिंग लाइंस बाय स्वामी विवेकानंद. Never think there is anything impossible for the soul. It is the greatest heresy to think so. And if there is sin, this is the only sin. To say that you are weak, to say that others are weak. So I think this is a perfect day to celebrate the youth and the youth festival. As many as 1,550 students participated in 13 different competitions for 2 complete days. All of them fought hard in the creative contest, displaying enormous talents and the qualities of hand and heart. There was excitement in the air. The campus was turned into a carnival of creativity. The atmosphere for the last 2 days was electrifying, and the war cries of winning was reverberating in the air. These 3 days of creative commotion and contesting are coming to end. We always wish that some good occasions never come to end. But well, as all good things do, today we are standing at the closing ceremony of otherwise a very, very energetic youth festival that we've had. As we move on the function, I would very earnestly request Dr. Rajendra Patel, in charge Registrar, V. Narmad South Gujarat University, for a welcome address.
Namaskar. V. Narmad Dakshin Gujarat University, na 47th Yuvak Mahotsav. નું અંતિમ ચરણ વિજયશ્રી ના પ્રસંગે તથા નમો ટેબ્લેટ વિતરણ કાર્યક્રમના અધ્યક્ષ માનનીય આપણી યુનિવર્સિટીના કુલપતિ ડૉક્ટર શિવેન્દ્ર ગુપ્તા સર, આજના અતિથિ વિશેષ ભારતીય ક્રિકેટ ટીમના પૂર્વ કેપ્ટન અને આંતરરાષ્ટ્રીય ક્રિકેટમાં સૌથી ઊંચી શિખર પર પહોંચેલ વ્યક્તિ માનનીય દિલીપ વેન્સરકર સર, ડેવિડ પોલ સર, સેનેટ સિન્ડિકેટના સભ્યશ્રીઓ, વિવિધ વિભાગના વડાશ્રીઓ, અધ્યાપકગણ, આચાર્યશ્રીઓ, વિદ્યાર્થી મિત્રો, જેમણે આ પ્રતિયોગિતામાં ભાગીદારી લીધી છે, એવા તમામ કલાકાર મિત્રો, પ્રેસના મીડિયાઓ, પ્રેસ અને મીડિયાના મિત્રો, તથા આમંત્રિતો આ મહાઉત્સવના ઉદ્ઘાટન પ્રસંગ અને સમાપન પ્રસંગે આપણે વિશેષ વ્યક્તિઓ તરીકે ક્રિકેટના વ્યક્તિઓને મેળવ્યા છે. એક વિશેષ આનંદની બાબત છે. બીજી બાબત એ છે કે બે દિવસ ચાલેલા એ કાર્યક્રમો વિવિધ કાર્યક્રમોમાં વિદ્યાર્થીઓએ ખરેખર સાચા અર્થમાં પોતાની કૃતિઓમાં વિજય મેળવ્યો છે. મને વિશેષ આનંદ એ થાય છે કે આ કાર્યક્રમ ખરેખર વિજયશ્રી અર્થમાં પૂર્ણ થઈ રહ્યો છે. અહીં ઉપસ્થિત સર્વેનો હું યુનિવર્સિટી વતી હૃદયપૂર્વક આવકારું છું, સ્વાગત કરું છું. ધન્યવાદ.
થેન્ક યુ સર ફોર ધ વેલકમ એડ્રેસ. ટુડે વી આર હિયર ટુ વિટનેસ ટુ મોમેન્ટસ ઓકેઝન્સ. વન ઇઝ ઓફકોર્સ ધી અવોર્ડ સેરેમની ફોર ધ 47th યુથ ફેસ્ટિવલ ઓફ ધીસ યુનિવર્સિટી, વેર વી આર ગોઈંગ ટુ સેલિબ્રેટ ધ વિનર્સ એન્ડ ઓફકોર્સ ઓલ્સો અપ્લોડ ઓલ ધોઝ હુ કુડન્ટ મેક ઇટ ટુ ધ ટોપ. ધ સેકન્ડ વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ઇવેન્ટ ઇઝ ધ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુશન ઓફ ધ નમો ઈ ટેબ્લેટ્સ વિચ ઇઝ ગોઈંગ ટુ ટેક પ્લેસ ટુડે. We will take this program forward with welcoming our chief guest today, Shri Dilip Vengsarkar ji. I request our honorable vice chancellor Dr. Shivendra Gupta ji to welcome sir with a floral bouquet and a memento. On behalf of Veer Narmad South Gujarat University, we extend a warm welcome to you, sir. I now would request Dr. Rajendra Patel, our in-charge registrar, to welcome our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Shivendra Gupta, with flowers. We welcome you, sir. I request Mr. Paul David to give a warm floral welcome to Dr. Rajendra Patel, our in-charge registrar. Thank you, sir. Today we have amidst us Mr. Dilip Vengsarkar, former captain of Indian cricket team and a world-class cricketer. Dilip ji needs no introduction. We are a country of cricket fans, and anyone who has followed cricket over the years would have seen him play or have heard about his glorious cricketing history. For our very young cricket fans here, I must take this opportunity to tell you that he was known as one of the foremost exponents of the drive. He played for the Indian cricket team from 1976 to 1992, a long span of 17 years in international cricket. In his career, he has played a total of 116 test matches, 129 ODIs, and about 260 first-class matches. He has a total of 17 test centuries and 35 half-test centuries to his credit. He has a total of 73 centuries in all match formats during his career. He was a part of the 1983 World Champions team. He was one of the few batsmen who was successful against the deadly West Indies bowlers of the 70s and 80s. He usually batted as number 3 or number 4 in all formats of the game, and all of you who follow cricket would know how important that batting position is in the game of cricket. He was awarded with the Arjuna Award on his on-field performance for his on-field performance in 1981. He was decorated with the Padma Shri in 1987 for his overall contribution to the game of cricket. He was also awarded as Wisden Cricketer of the Year in 1987. And the BCCI honored him with the C.K. Naidu Lifetime Achievement Award. He is currently a team member and coach for the Telugu Warrior team in the Celebrity Cricket League. We welcome you, sir, and I would like to welcome him here for his address as the chief guest of this function.
I'm wondering whether I should speak in Gujarati or in English. Gujarati mein baat karu ki? Actually, mara ghana bada friend Gujarati che. Karsan Gavri, Ashok Mankadata, a lot of players those who played with me in Gujarat, I think from Gujarat. પણ મને કાઠિયાવાડી આવડે છે. અમારા એક ઓપનિંગ બેટ્સમેન હતા, હી યુઝ ટુ ગેટ બોલ્ડ મોસ્ટ ઓફ ધ ટાઈમ એન્ડ હી વોઝ ફ્રોમ રાજકોટ. તો વી યુઝ ટુ આસ્ક હિમ, હું તો ગયો જશું, એને કહે બેટ અને પેડમાં વચ્ચે ગેપ હતી, આમાંથી દડો ઘૂસી ગયો. But I had a fantastic time in Gujarat. Every time, whenever I played, whether it's Ahmedabad or Rajkot or even Surat, there was a captain of Bombay team when we played here, and it was Sachin Tendulkar's first year at Bombay, and when Virat Kohli's first match in Surat, sir, and he scored a 50 in the first game itself, and then Sachin and had a long partnership that time. I remember he was very young, I think 15, 16 years of age, and we had a great at the innings together against Gujarat. But of course, Gujarat over the years has done extremely well. And I picked Irfan Pathan and Parthiv Patel when I was selector, when they had not played for the state also. In our time, Bombay was a formidable team. And Gujarat has come up very nicely, and now they can beat Bombay as well. So it's a big, big progress for their team, Gujarat team. And Parthiv Patel and everybody, they have done extremely well over the years. My heartiest congratulations to the university. I think, you know, I had met Shivendra Guptaji, that's what he said, some 78 years ago, in 1978. When I think he had written a book on cricket, so he wanted some autographs. I was playing at that time and I helped him. I don't remember, but he remembers very vividly. But that was a fantastic thing, because you have been very lucky that you are vice chancellor, Shivendra Gupta, who is so fond of cricket, who is so fond of sports for that matter. And he is giving 100% to the university. So, sir, very well done. I hope you continue for many years to come, because I think sports is an integral part of any human being, and sports are very, very important, because if you are physically fit, then I think you are mentally alert. So everybody should play sport. I think it may be cricket, you know, football, hockey, or whatever game you choose to play. But then, I think when you play the state level, of course, I think you'll be playing the state level later on, and maybe for India as well, I think some of you. When you play the state level, it's important to grab the opportunity. I remember that I was a captain of Bombay Schools team. I was a captain of Indian Schools team. I was a captain of Indian Varsity team, which played against MCC, against England. And then I was selected to play at the Bombay team. And that time, our team was captained by Gavaskar. We had Ekna Solkar, Ashok Mankad, Karsan Ghavi, all stalwarts. And I was 17, 18 years of age. And for the entire year, they asked me to do the scoring, you know, with the scorebook. I was doing scoring all the time. I was so upset. I said to myself that I can be equal to anybody, for that matter, those who are playing. And they were established test match cricketers. And I had not played even for Bombay. But I had confidence in myself, my ability. And I said, if I get an opportunity, I will score 100. But I got an opportunity the next year when Ekna Solo got injured. And I was asked to play in the playing 11. That was Irani Cup match, so you remember. It was Bombay versus the rest of India. And their team was led by Bishan Singh Bedi. And their Prasanna and everybody. They all stalwarts. They were playing at that time for India. I got an opportunity and I said, this is an opportunity for me. I must grab it with both hands. And I scored 100, hitting 7 or 8 sixes against Bishan Bedi and Prasanna. And that got me in the limelight. And the next match I played for India. So that was a thing like, when you get an opportunity, just grab it. Because these opportunities come very few in life. So grab the opportunity. And then discipline is very important. You have to be disciplined. Because if you want to play for 20 years, 25 years of at the highest level, then you got to be disciplined. And I'm passionate about cricket. Because I've seen these guys, when I picked Virat Kohli in the team, at the chairman selection committee, I just picked him because I saw him play very well in Australia in the emerging players tournament. And Virat, over the years, has improved so much that now at the moment he's the best batsman in the world. Simply because he works so hard at his fitness. He's extremely fit. And he works at least 2 to 3 hours every day in the gym, runs, he swims. And that is what you can see out on the cricket field, and that is why he's the best in the world. And so did Sachin Tendulkar. And you could see his passion because he used to just the bat all the time in the nets, in the match, all the time. I used to think about cricket all the time. And now there's so much money in the game, but there are some players, they just went away from the game because they earned so much money in the game. So they just lost the interest, lost the hunger to do well. But having said that, there might be some good players amongst you all, but you got to be mentally fit, are they mentally alert, and mentally very strong. In early 70s, Gavaskar was emerged in India as the best batsman. He played for 20 years. And then the people were wondering who's the next. Then we had Sachin Tendulkar. He played 25 years. After Sachin, people were asking who's next. Then there is Virat Kohli. He's the best batsman in the world at the moment. After Virat, who? Now there might be a player amongst you that you might take his place in an Indian team in future. All the best to you. Thank you very much for inviting me. And God bless you all. Thank you.
जो तूफानों में पले जा रहे हैं वो दुनिया बदले जा रहे हैं दैट वॉज द कर्नल ऑफ क्रिकेट फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू इट वॉज सो वेरी इंस्पायरिंग टू लिसन टू यू सर समबडी हु बिगैन एज अ स्कोरर इज नाउ डिफाइनिंग हाउ क्रिकेट शुड बी प्लेड इन द वर्ल्ड थैंक यू वेरी मच सर फॉर योर इंस्पायरिंग वर्ड्स नाउ We move to a much awaited address, presidential address. I would request our visionary vice chancellor and an orator and a shire to come forward and give his presidential address.
Respected Dilip Veng Sarkar ji, in charge registrar Shri Rajendra Patel ji, Shri David Paul ji, my professor friends and my kids. I am feeling honored by the presence of Sir Dilip Veng Sarkar. I want to tell you why. In 1980, I wrote the second work on cricket. The first one was India's tour of Australia 1977-78, where Bishan Singh Bedi was India's captain, and Bobby Simpson was the captain of Australia. That was at the time when Kerry Packer series took place. Then I wrote next in 1979, Pakistan's tour of India, of which Dilip Vengsarkar was a member of the team. I had written the book, and there was a tournament going on in Surat, and there was just one so-called five-star hotel called Oasis, where all these players were staying. I can name the players: Chetan Chauhan, Dilip Vengsarkar, G.R. Vishwanath, Kapil Dev, Surinder Amarnath. They all were staying, and I had gone there to take their autographs, but nobody was giving me much bhao, and they thought that I am just a kid. But Dilip Vengsarkar, he noticed me and said, "You have written all this?" I said, "Yes, sir, I have." So he took me to each player and got me the autograph. He was extremely kind, and I have showed him both the books today. The books that I had written at that time, I showed him those books. So besides being a great cricketer, he's a gentleman at heart, extremely kind, extremely loving. And I tell you that I have known so many people in the world, but in his presence, I am feeling as if I am in the presence of a brother. Believe me, that sort of feeling I am having. Dilip Vengsarkar was known as the Colonel of cricket. He played at Lords. Every time he played, he scored a century. That is not a small milestone. No other batsman in the world has achieved this. Every time he played at Lords, he scored a century. And I have watched all those innings completely and fully. Every moment I have enjoyed. You see, today's bowlers are not that world class. They might be world class, but at that time, fast bowling was really world class. At that time, it was difficult. In his earlier part, I believe you did not even have a helmet to wear in the initial stage. Later on, maybe in 92 or 90, the helmet was discovered and it was worn by cricketers. To face fast bowling without a helmet was the real test of manhood, courage. You see, at that time, he played cricket. His average was an astounding 42. You might be thinking, how does that compare with modern players who have an average of 50 plus? I believe 42 is much better than many of the 50 plus during modern age, because that was the age when true fast bowlers, true spinners were in action. At that time, players like Dilip Vengsarkar prospered and brought glory to India. I tell you, later on, Rahul Dravid was known as Mr. Dependable. At one time, in my opinion, he was the most dependable number three or number four batsman for India. I will not take much of your time, but because people know me of my shairies and all, so I will recite very simple ghazal. You will understand that. I will not speak tough Urdu because it takes some time to explain that. But this is a very simple ghazal. Ke hans ke bola karo, bulaya karo. Hans ke bola karo, bulaya karo. Aapka ghar hai, aaya jaya karo. Hans ke bola karo, bulaya karo. Aapka ghar hai, aaya jaya karo. मुस्कुराहट है हुस्न का जेवर सुंदरता का मुस्कुराहट है हुस्न का जेवर मुस्कुराना ना भूल जाया करो मुस्कुराना ना भूल जाया करो और आखिरी शेर है कि हद से बढ़कर हसीन लगते हो हद से बढ़कर हसीन लगते हो झूठी कसमें जरूर खाया करो
सो दैट वाज the natural style of sir who normally ends his addresses with some meaningful ghazals. and brings the audiences alive. Along with this prize distribution ceremony, we are also having a Namo Tab distribution program. And we would now head towards that. As all of us know, Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has introduced this Namo Tabs to ensure that the students participate in this IT revolution and take benefit from it. These tabs have been helping students change their lives, and there are thousands of them distributed every year. I would now request students whose name I read to come forward and receive the tablet from the dignitaries on dais. I'm speaking the names, and I request the students to come here on stage. All right, the first one is Aniket Patel, Nandini Sedani, Tamakuwala Parishi, Tarsarya Karan, Manpara Dikshit, Tejani Shruti, Kantharya Jainit, Dobarya Itisha, Padmani Darshan, Prajapati Nidhi. All these students, please come one by one and receive your tablets. I think these students are lucky because they're going to receive these tablets from this cricketing icon who is with us today. I think breaking from the slumber, the audience should continue to applaud.